Many of them appear as though they are your average middle-class Australians. But a new report has found more and more students, single parents and renters are slipping below the poverty line as cost of living pressures bite. It sparked an urgent call for support payments to be adjusted.
White picket fence, green grass, suburban Brizzy home. But uni student Brock Alexander's life is anything but rosy.
It's extremely difficult. I can't afford to register my car. I can't afford to eat every day of the week. Sometimes I can't even afford to pay my parents money that they use to help pay their mortgage.
The 24-year-old has taken to desperate measures to rake in an extra $20 or $30 a week.
So at night time, I go down to the local shopping centre and I collect the 10-cent bottles and cans to redeem the 10 cents. I do it for about 7 hours a week.
This is the emerging face of poverty in Australia, as revealed by a shocking new report by ACOSS and the Uni of New South Wales.
That we have one in eight people, including one in six children, who are living in poverty.
Single mum Angela Finch's three kids are among them.
I hate the tooth fairy. I hate canteen lunches. I hate birthday party invitations. I hate Christmas and Easter.
They're calling for an urgent reset in the May federal budget.
We want to see all income support payments of working age going up to the pension rate. That would be a minimum of $76 per day.
The youth allowance is around $40 a day. That's about $15,000 a year to live off. When the minimum wage is $45,000 a year, you can see why many are saying they just can't afford to study.
I had to give it up to get insecure, low-paid, casual work, so I'm on the wheel of poverty. I can't get off anymore.
Unless positive policy steps are taken. Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.